allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, roll call.
Mr. Katara?
Here.
Mr. Kraus?
Here.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Here.
Mr. Palunas?
Here.
Mr. Russo? Mr. Scott?
Here.
All right, I don't believe there's any changes to the agenda, the announcements as read. Just announcing, we will have a couple of budget hearings, one being next Monday, the 13th, 5 o'clock, and then on the 20th. Which is the following Monday, also at 5 o'clock. Brings us to comments from the audience. Any comments from the audience? Going once, going twice, okay. Approval of our minutes from October 16th of 2017.
Move to approve as submitted.
Councilwoman Meany.
Second.
Councilman Scott. Roll call.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.
All right. Brings us to our Planning Commission consent. Item one.
An application was received from David J. Sarver for a property located at 5800 Ledgebrook Lane. The Planning Commission approved a 131.5-foot front yard setback variance contingent upon the filing of a consolidation plat prior to the issuance of the permit. Planning Commission also approved a not parallel to the street variance, a 14-foot maximum driveway width variance, a 4-foot minimum driveway width variance, maximum number of accessory structures variance, accessory structure location variance, 596 square foot maximum accessory structure area variance, and also approved a lot consolidation of permanent parcel 952-33006 and 952-33022, and that was contingent upon the applicant's notation on the plat acknowledging that the property owner shall be solely responsible for the storm sewer on the property and removing any liability from the city of Solon.
Okay, Bob?
I will move to approve the item number one on the Planning Commission consent agenda.
Motion by Councilman Palunas, second by Councilman McGill. Roll call on the consent of Planning Commission.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Excuse me. Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.
All right.
On item number two, I will move to schedule a public hearing at the next regular council meeting for the request from Omni Properties to rezone the permanent parcel numbers referred to on our agenda.
A motion by Councilman Palunas,
second
by Councilman McGill. Roll call, so that will be at the November 20th meeting.
Yes.
Okay. Roll call.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.
All right, we have a couple items under pending. Item three.
Ordinance number 2017-163A, and ordinance adopting the annual appropriations for personal services and other expenditures of the City of Solon for the period January 1st, 2017 to December 31st, 2017, and declaring an emergency. And this is the third reading.
Councilman Palunas.
Yes, I'll move for passage of ordinance number 2017-163A.
Okay, motion by Councilman Palunas, second by Councilman McGill. Roll call.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
No.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
No.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.
All right, passes 4-2. Okay. Item four.
Ordinance number 2017-183, and ordinance amending section 1288.043D of the zoning code entitled Non-Commercial Opinion Signs, and this is the second reading.
Okay, we will keep this on second reading. Brings us to our consent. Item five.
Ordinance number 2017-184, and ordinance authorizing the mayor or her designee to enter into an agreement with Channel Products Incorporated under the Job Creation Grant Program and declaring an emergency.
Mark.
This legislation approves, authorizes the mayor to enter into a job creation grant with Channel Products that is located at 30700 Industrial Parkway. The project will result in an approximate investment of $1.6 million and an additional 64 employees to the city with an estimated $5.3 million of new payroll. This legislation is also for a 40% payroll tax grant for a period of 7 years.
Okay, item six.
Ordinance number 2017-185, and ordinance accepting the final contract adjustment with AAA Flexible Pipe for the 2016 Annual Sewer Grouting Program.
Doug.
This is the final contract adjustment for, with AAA Flexible Pipe for the 2016 Annual Sewer Grouting Program. This closes out ordinance number 2016-126A in the amount of $180,190.92, which is $46,207 below the original contract amount.
Okay, item seven.
Ordinance number 2017-186, and ordinance authorizing the mayor to enter into an inspection and maintenance agreement with J.P. Morgan Chase Bank for stormwater best management practices for 6396 Somme Center Road.
Bob.
Yes, this was approved at our Public Works Committee meeting. This is a standard agreement that we've entered into with other properties in the area for the stormwater management of the detention basin at this facility.
Okay, item eight.
Ordinance number 2017-187, and ordinance amending ordinance number 2017-15 to modify the proposal of Burgess and Nyepel to include services for additional design items as part of the Somme Center retaining wall refacing and fence replacement project.
Mark.
The engineering department has been working with Burgess and Nyepel as part of our engineering contract that we have with Burgess and Nyepel for the purposes of the Somme Center retaining wall resurfacing and the fence replacement project. During this process, there were several additional items that had to be addressed. And so this legislation approves a contract modification in the amount of $35,100 with Burgess and Nyepel to address the additional design items.
Item nine.
Ordinance number 2017-188, and ordinance accepting the bid of PVS Technologies Incorporated for the purchase of ferric chloride for use by the Water Reclamation Department.
Doug.
Ferric chloride is used by the Water Reclamation Department to leach out phosphorus from water that they're treating. And there were two bidders on this contract per ordinance 2016-138. The lowest and best bidder was PBS Technologies in the amount of $488 per dry ton.
Okay, item 10.
Ordinance number 2017-189, and ordinance authorizing the mayor to execute a contract with Burgess and Nyepel for general engineering design services for the years 2018 and 2019. And this ordinance should be approved as read.
Bob.
Yes, this was approved at our last Public Works Committee meeting, and the rates, as you can see, are very, very slightly above, and this is as read. So this is going to be for 2018 and 2019. The actual ordinance that we were provided in our packet just said 2018, so that's a change that's going to be on there for 2 years, and the rates are as stated in the attachments and the exhibits. And it is a recommendation of Public Works Committee to approve this.
Okay. Tom.
Are you saying it's going to be 2 years now and not,
yes,
even though it's written? Just because it's 2 years, can you make a motion to amend?
Okay, we discussed that in caucus, and Carol decided to do recommended that we could do it as read, but I will.
Just
the
substantive
point,
part about it, I'd prefer just an overabundance of caution, if you would, okay?
I will move to amend the ordinance to authorizing the mayor to execute a contract with Burgess and Nyepel for general engineering contract services for the year 2018-2019 in an effort to appease Mr. Lobey's abundance of caution, even
Thank
though
you.
I don't necessarily know if it's necessary because Carol was correct in saying as well.
Second.
Motion and second on the motion to amend. Roll call.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Excuse me, Mr. Krause?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.
Okay, now we need a motion on consent.
Mr. Chairman, I'll make a motion that we, under suspension, pass the consent.
Motion by Councilman Scott, second by Councilman McGill. Roll call, under suspension.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.
Final passing.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.
All right, brings us to the end of our agenda. Comments from the audience? Any comments from the audience? Going once, going twice? Okay. Comments from councils? Bob?
Looking forward to seeing everyone at the polls tomorrow, wishing all the candidates best of luck, and the election being held tomorrow, and the polling place is open at 6:30 a.m. So I know most of us will be there in the morning, and very good luck, and that's my comments.
Nancy?
Okay, I just wanted to make an announcement. The Kiwanis are having their annual pancake breakfast this Sunday at the Solon Community Center, and that will take place from 8 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. And also just want to tell everybody, please get out and vote. And to everybody up here, because I think I'm the only one not running, good luck to all of you. And like I say, please vote.
John?
Yes, I had a conversation with our state representative, Marlene Anielski, and you may have seen the picture in the Times maybe one issue back, but we now, through her legislation, we have a Solon Comet vanity plate, which, you know, if you saw the picture, it looks really nice. The little drawback to it is the fact that it costs $40 more, but it gets better because 30 of the $40 comes back to the schools to be used strictly for our students who are in need. So it's a worthwhile thing, I think, but you better hurry, because I think Mr. Katura is going to buy every one of them first. I wish everybody good luck tomorrow. I know everybody's worked very hard. And being from Chicago, vote early and vote often. Thank you.
Doug?
We still have some houses that have some power out. And I wanted to say to First Energy, thanks for your diligence working. I know they've been working around the clock to repair. This is a pretty serious outage in Twinsburg. But still in Somerset, and I think Lisa Lane, we have some houses out. But I want to say thank you to Bill Dursick and the service department. They responded very quickly and cleared branches and trees and did a great job. Thank you, Bill. I appreciate that. A couple other quick things. Tomorrow, just remember the poll workers when you go to vote. Most of those people will be there from about 5:30 until at least 7:30, if not 8 o'clock. They do get paid, but it is a very long day, and they're all very diligent. So say thank you to them if you get a chance. They're really doing an important job for us. Same thing with the poll volunteers. If you see people out there saying signs, at least smile to them and say hi, because they believe in the process that we're undergoing here, and they're working very hard, and they deserve your support. Finally, a number of people have asked me, my son Michael's returned from Afghanistan, a combat veteran now, just been promoted to captain, and so I'm very grateful that he has returned to us. Thank you.
Mark?
I'd like to echo the comments of my colleagues, and I am looking forward to seeing Ward 4 residents at the polls throughout the, on and off throughout the day tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to echo the comments. First off, good luck to the folks, especially down south, that suffered power outages. Thanks, Bill, and your crew, and First Energy as well. And I want to wish everyone good luck. Most of my colleagues up here, there's folks in the audience, just want to wish everyone the best of luck. It's a long day, but it's a great opportunity to meet all the voters in the city. So those are my comments. Comments from the administration, starting with Mr. Lobe.
No comments.
Carol?
I just wish everybody good luck tomorrow at the polls.
Chief?
The annual Solon Police Department food drive has begun. So there are orange barrels at various different municipal buildings, as well as at the police department lobby. And we'll be collecting food for donations to those in need, and would appreciate people's thoughts in that regard. Thank you.
Chief?
No comments, thank you.
Matt?
No comments tonight, thanks.
Rob?
Nothing tonight.
Bill?
Yes, just thank you, Councilman McGill, for the kind words. Just to give the council a quick update, crews received a call from Sherwin Valley Dispatch about 7 o'clock last evening with two trees down on Aurora Road. We cleaned those up right away, and throughout the evening, we received calls for down trees in Somerset and Rolling Brook. We removed those hazards and pushed them off to the side. We also put up some road close signs at Liberty Road, just south of Pettibone, because of the issue going down there. And throughout the day today, we had five crews out cleaning up throughout the day. They did a great job. I'm very proud of all of them. We cleaned up trees and finished up Aurora Road, Somme Center, White Oak. There was one across the sidewalk. Pettibone, up from Rolling Brook to 43, there were a lot of dead branches that fell with the winds. That's cleaned up. Fawn Path, we had a tree that was uprooted and blocking somebody's driveway. That's been taken care of. And on Ports Parkway, there is still a tree that's kind of hung up with another tree. It's about 50 feet tall. We're going to have to get an outside contractor for that one. And the only other thing I have to add is the traffic signal on Somme and Lisa is still under generator power right now. And night crew will be monitoring that throughout the night. And with regards to leaves, we've picked up roughly 5,500 yards of leaves so far, which gets us about halfway through. And we're on our fifth pass through the city.
Thank you. John?
No comments tonight.
Peggy? Okay. I think that's it. Is there a motion to adjourn? John? Second by Nancy. Roll call on a motion to adjourn.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Scott?
Yes.